What's good, everybody? We have literally 5 seconds or so until Summer Games Fest starts. We are here. I'm joined today by Ryder Maldonado, James Walmer. My name is Vincent DeSantis. We're from Strictly Casual, and we are ready for this program. Whatever Jeff Keighley's got for us today. Yeah. Let's freaking go. What do you guys hope to see?
Oh my Elden God. Ring.
That's the you only said thing Sony. Anything from Sony, and I'll eat it up. That's for me.
I'm ready for everything.
Here we go. Here we go.
Look at this man.
I'm interested to see how much or how little Sony shows.
That was a shot.
Right on time. Let me turn off captions. There we go. Prime Gaming.
I'm Jeff Keighley, and buckle up because we've got a big show for you, filled with new game announcements, world premieres, updates on the games you play every day, some surprises, and special guests, including Jeff Goldblum, Giancarlo Esposito, and performances by Weezer, Japanese Breakfast,
nice.
And the Sonic the Hedgehog Symphony Orchestra. Yes, that's really a thing.
Oh, that's cool.
Now, like a great video game, there may be some twists along the way today, and just wait until you see what we have planned for the end game.
Oh.
That is all I'm allowed to tell you right now.
End game.
This oh, please. It's going to be like Avengers and Fortnite again.
Yeah, yeah.
No. I wasn't saying that to you. I was saying that to Jeff.
Bethesda, Square Enix, Ubisoft, and more. You can head right now to summergamefest.com to track all the events.
It's not E3.
There's a lot of great stuff coming your way.
It's not E3.
But you're right, Brax. We kick things I love off it.
With a big 90-minute cross
this is the most classic chains up in the world.
Meant to put platforms and rivalries aside. We will have updates and news.
Also, Vin, take a shot. Switch, t-shirt and blazer.
Or Xbox. The biggest games in the world will be here, and some of the smallest ones too, made by emerging voices and developers.
Those shoes are designer, though.
Represent what's next. Thank
you.
You
think they're
so
custom made? I feel like he gets some custom free show. He does.
Video game summer.
Yeah, those are so sick. Well, I don't know what they are, but they're really cool.
Video game summer? It's Hot Boy Summer.
You're about to see the world premiere of the next great adventure.
Elden Ring.
From Gearbox.
Gearbox.
2K.
Ooh, another new IP.
Not Borderlands.
Yeah.
Yep. Well, what's up, Cheese?
The font.
You might be still ahead, Ryder, just by a tad.
Okay.
Yeah, so hold the reactions a little bit.
Half second.
Give it
just
a second.
Second.
Yeah, I'll act along with you guys. Fate.
It's still shell shaded.
It soars on. It is. It's kind of just Gearbox.
Tell me what
thing.
You're seeing. Just like 1 second. Let me hear. What do
something
you
came out of the grave just now.
Okay, we're right on time. That's the
thing. I just saw the thing come out of the grave.
Oh, okay. I think me and Vinny are right on exactly the same. You cannot
hide. After this trailer, I'll try and like.
Okay.
Bump it up.
Mm-hmm. But dude, I like the art style.
Make your own. It's just typical Gearbox 3D. Mm-hmm. It's all shaded.
Starring you, the gamer. Andy! What?
Andy Samberg?
Wanda Sykes? What the heck?
Oh.
Doctor
Andy
Strange?
Samberg.
Looks like Will Doctor Arnett? Strange. That looks like a sorcerer.
What is this?
Oh, Ashley Birch, classic. And her royal highness? What's the joke? Butt Stallion? Is this like based off that
Apple
TV Plus
show?
Yeah.
This is gonna be a comedy game.
Yeah. Yeah. This is like a. So it's a spinoff. Of
Wonderlands?
Of the Borderlands universe.
Okay.
Yeah, Wonderlands.
Tiny Tinas? Sorry, I mean,
Oh, that's cool.
I won't say it. I feel like I'm safe.
Oh, no, you're good. You're good.
Early 2022.
If you could hold off a second, that'd be cool.
If you could hold off a sec, please. Yeah.
Tiny Tina.
Oh,
Borderlands
actually,
Borderlands.
Cool.
And joining us now is Tiny Tina herself, Ashley Birch. Hey, Ash. How you
what's
doing?
Oh, okay. I wasn't too familiar with the world. Sorry.
Only played Borderlands 2.
Never
Josh, you can't say it looks mad if you've never played a Borderlands game. Question.
It's,
you don't have the right.
My fantasy take on a looter shooter, as you saw. And,
she's in a.
If you're a fan of Borderlands, you'll probably recognize
Apple TV Plus show.
Fantasy elements inspired
quest.
By Assault on Dragon Keep, which was the Borderlands 2 DLC that was beloved by
the who
devs.
Are we talking
and
to
so
the new
this
Ashley Birch?
Kind of inspired Wonderlands.
There's a guy who came on our show.
The elephant in the room is this a Borderlands game? Is it not? How does it
relate? Oh, yeah, yeah.
So it actually isn't. It's own standalone game.
Professor Shaggy.
People that love Borderlands are going to find lots of elements to love about Wonderlands, but it's
I actually
its own
should be
thing.
Listening
Tiny Tina's got her own thing going on now. So it's got its own mechanics. There's spell casting. You can customize your character this time, which is super exciting. And yeah, so if you love Borderlands, you're going to find stuff to love in this. And if you've never played a Borderlands game, this
I think
is
she's so underrated. She has so much, so many good projects.
Her own game, which is fantastic. What is her role? Why does she get her own game?
So she is your bunker master. She's kind of guiding the narrative
Wonka
and
Master.
Changing it on a dime if she wants. And she's just taking your cast of characters, which is an amazing cast,
through so it's like
this
D&D
wacky
style.
World, and she's taking you on an adventure to defeat the Dragon Lord. And who is that? I don't know. You'll have to play.
I wonder who plays the Dragon Lord, because you can bring the voice cast, including you in this, which is awesome.
Dude, so the voice cast is a like banger in this.
So this was a bit of a tease, announcing it's out there. When will we find out more about this game?
Hopefully this summer.
Someone says hopefully.
You can find out a lot more at playwonderlands.com if you'd like.
We tweet that we're live on our Twitter, by the way.
Stay tuned for
us. Yes.
All right, coming early 2022. So look forward to next year. Ash, thank you so much for joining us in person.
Thanks for having me.
I'm excited.
And we'll see more later.
It looks like the game from her show Mythic Quest. It looks just like that game. Literally Mythic Quest.
This one you probably are not expecting.
Another new IP.
Classic 90s franchise is coming back to life.
Oh, I wouldn't know.
A grid-based tactical strategy title for Steam on PC. This is an insanely fun trailer. I hope you'll enjoy it.
Nice.
World premiere.
Oh! I see this art style. Cool. I instantly look to y'all.
Metal Gear Slug? Or Metal Slug? Whatever it's called. Dang it, what is it called?
No, it's just cool though.
It is! It is!
You know it is?
It's an arcade game.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool. Metal Slug, guys.
Jeez, Metal Slug something.
She's got it in.
Dude!
Oh, is it like a tactical one? Like XCOM style? That'd be sick. I would play the shit out of this if this was an XCOM style Metal Slug game.
This is awesome.
This is really cool. This is fun.
This is a Switch game for me. This would be a perfect Switch game.
Switch house game. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Cheesy, like turn-based, squad-based.
This is actually really cool.
That's a nice trailer.
And this is your gateway drug into XCOM.
I enjoy those type of games, James. It just takes me. I have to get past a point where I get really into it. Like I got to learn all the systems, then I love it.
Right, because they do have a lot of systems.
I get turned off when I like don't put a lot of time in the beginning. You know what I mean? And then I get like overwhelmed. This is just how I remember, dude. That's so sick.
Metal Slug.
Metal Slug Tactics.
Tactics.
Sweet.
I said Metal Gear Slug at the beginning.
Metal Gear Slug.
Okay, we have another big announcement for you from a surprise guest, but it's well past 3 a.m. their time, so don't worry. We chatted earlier, and I'm very excited to share this with you right now.
Africa?
Hello, mystery guest.
New LA Thieves merch?
Mr. Kojima, it is so good to see you. Thank you for joining us in Tokyo. First of all, I just want to ask,
I told you,
doing,
bitches.
How are you feeling? Yeah. How are things right now?
Mention the J. Cole lyric. Mention the J. Cole lyric.
Oh, I didn't remember.
What if Jeff Keighley just started speaking in Japanese to Hideo?
It's so good. I wouldn't doubt it. Wouldn't doubt it.
Well, we certainly hope that you're going to get your vaccine soon.
I love Jeff's setup. It's so clean.
It's so cool.
You
got the Battering Game Awards trophy.
He says this says a lot about society.
He said we live in a society.
Yeah. Oh my God.
あったんですけど今回のDSに関してはもう発売直後になったので、え、Death Stranding。かなりものの考え方が変わったというか、ものづくりのスタンスがちょっと変わったというか、いろいろ考えました。あの今後のものづくり、あのやっぱりエンターテインメントである以上、まあ、It has to be fun.
Death Stranding is on my list. I have to play it.
なんていうの、フィクションなくなってしまうので、で、なんで今回のコロナの中で、この先をどう作るかっていうのは、いろいろ考えましたね。あの、他のクリエイターも多分
Oh, wow.
That's true. The world is different now.
Well, I know we are all very curious about what the next era of Hideo Kojima Entertainment is going to be. I don't know how much you can say, but can you give us any sense of kind of where your mind's at right now, what you're thinking about, some of the themes or the ideas?
Horror.
Yeah, absolutely.
It won't be one step at a time.
Okay.
It's 9/11.
Yeah.
9/11 comparison.
The world was different, yeah.
That's true. Very much a global change.
Mm-hmm. The way people do things.
Yeah.
An alien?
You got to think about this.
Yeah.
This man is going to be creating something
very
like,
philosophical.
Yeah.
There's going to be points to it for sure. Yeah.
What's up, Sly? What's good? Welcome in.
Yeah, he just said he wants to introduce like societal things into this game to like
awesome.
Have people think about society while still allowing them to have fun.
Wow, this is cool. Take us out of this lull period.
Metal Gear Rising.
I tried.
Two.
Mr. Kojima, honestly, I really appreciate you making the time to stop by and just say hello to everyone. We miss you, and we can't wait to see what you're working on next. So thank you.
Awesome.
Jeff, God bless you, Kojima.
So great.
One more thing.
Oh, yes. What is this? No
PlayStation.
Way. He said, here's the trailer. Oh, Death Stranding.
They debated us so bad.
Oh, wow.
They really did debate us
DLC.
So bad.
Or is this what, like a PS5 remaster?
I bet it's a PS5 version.
Okay. Wait, that looks like Resident Evil. The guck. Maybe, okay. I don't know why.
You might be right.
No,
that's right. Something they would do.
It looked like the guck from Resident Evil. From Biohazard.
Do that. Yeah. I mean, they might. I don't know.
It looks like Metal Gear Solid. Isn't that from... like the stealth with the what? Box, the box sections?
Dude.
Like where he has to hide in the box and go around?
Oh.
I think they're incorporating that now into this. Oh, I love the angle.
Looks like
gave me Metal Gear Solid vibes. Yeah.
The clickers.
Still got the baby. Dude, watch. We're gonna see a box.
Still got the baby. Let's go.
Do a lip of the baby. Oh my god, it's the box! Oh, no way! He's gonna
what
do
are
it.
What are gonna do?
He's gonna hide inside
gonna,
it.
He's gonna hide it? Handled wow. with love.
Fragile.
Fragile Express. Fragile.
Guys.
Oh, the oranges!
He's putting the box over his
those
head.
Those oranges look so good!
I know, I am, man. It's exciting.
Josh wouldn't understand. He hasn't played any of the Metal Gear games.
I'm just following the Nibel thread right now. It just goes, oh shit.
And?
He's contemplating the
yes!
box.
But yes.
Yes. A...
Oh! He jumped straight.
He went in backwards, though. You gotta have it over you, dip.
Wait, how's he gonna
get
flip it,
yet? It
over?
He's thinking about it. This is like contemplation.
Really...
This is Death Stranding,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
though. It's this slow. Dude. This is what Death Stranding is.
Have you
forever.
Played it, Ryder?
Yeah, I put a lot of... I put 60, 70 hours, maybe.
Oh, okay.
Just walking, man. Just peaceful walking. What? He gave up on that? Oh, I was going to say Metal Gear Solid collab. Director Scott!
I had Twitter spoil it for
no,
me.
Director
yeah.
Scott!
Director's cut.
Nice.
It's gonna be even
it's
longer.
10 hours.
Yeah,
it's
gonna be
hours
so
longer.
Long. Baby.
More missions, more walking.
Coming soon to PS5. Not PS4, just PS5.
Okay.
Oh nice. My god. Alright, we'll
there
see about that.
Death
he's so excited for Kojima, man.
Finally confirmed.
Love him.
I hope I make it into the director.
Finally.
I'm told the full reveal is just weeks away. Stay tuned. All right, next. What? It's my honor to welcome to Summer Game Fest a legendary actor who dedicated a whole episode
Goldblum?
Of his Disney Plus show to exploring the game. World of gaming
yep.
and has been
yeah,
in games like
Call of
Duty Black Ops 3. And we're thrilled to have him here at Summer Game Fest.
God bless him.
How are you, my friend?
Yes! Oh, wow.
So much.
Looks so good.
Joffrey. Sorry, I think it's Jeffrey. Hey, maybe it's Jeff. Hi, Jeff. Thank you so much, sincerely, for having me here. I'm thrilled to be here. Hey, I was
Joffrey.
Watching the show, and I was wondering...
Is this pre-recorded?
If there might be some video
oh, yeah, sure.
game world premieres, as you say.
Jurassic World?
And sure enough...
World
yeah,
premieres.
There is.
It's a Jurassic
yes,
World
Yes, we do like
two.
Our world premieres around here. Any chance you brought one with you today?
Well, it's funny you should say that. Yes,
perfectly
you could
timed.
Say yes, I do. If you don't mind, I've got something here. I'm going to read it on this. There's a little bit of a teleprompter that they're putting up here, so I'm going to read something because I don't want to get it wrong. I want to. I'm very.
Rico.
So here's a dramatic reading of this.
Ryder, you better hold your damn mouth.
I know. I won't say anything.
Hello. I'm here.
Whatever you do, you can react. Just don't read.
To a very different world. It's going to elevate you to new heights. It's going to submerge you to new depths.
I don't know, I'm thinking of it.
Maybe even challenge you.
Challenge you
to control chaos.
That's
actually, it's going to certainly challenge you to control chaos. It's a world so-called evolved.
Oh!
Take Sorry. A look at the... You guessed it, world premiere.
Is it what I think it is? World oh my God!
Premiere.
Is it...
Yes. Shut up, Ryder. Don't
oh
say
my
anything.
God. Yes. Give it to me. Let's go.
Yeah, there it is.
Oh yes, I love this game, man. I spent so many hours into evolution, evolve, or whatever. Used our power. Creating a park. Oh yes. Oh yes, I'm so excited for this.
Is it like a sequel to that?
Yes. Oh my God. Oh man.
Evolve isn't dead.
Yeah.
You thought cheesy.
It's not. It's not. I love it, man.
Hold on. I want to listen to this narration.
We weren't careful.
Oh, this is so
and
sick.
Now, here we are.
This is actually a cool ass trailer.
Yes. I love Jurassic
The camera
Park.
Movement is so cool.
A very different world.
Oh yeah! Yes! Let's go!
Oh, it's two.
I was so excited. This made my whole day. Yes, and you can
there
finally
you
do underwater parks. Oh my God, this year. This made my whole day. This is it.
I'm really liking these really soon release windows.
Yeah, Thank there's
God.
No like coming soon. They're all like 2021, 2022.
I mean, Death Stranding was coming
out
soon.
Now,
but...
and her book, Crying in H Mart, is a New York Times bestseller.
So happy.
Here now to perform Glider from the upcoming open world game Sable by Raw Fury and Shedworks. It's Japanese.
Are they showing Sable?
Maybe.
I've been following Sable for 10 effing years, and it's not coming out ever. I can't believe it's here right now.
They'll probably show some footage with this, right?
I've been following that developer for actually 5 years. This game's gonna be beautiful. Wow. Holy crap.
You've shown me this one. Looks really
I
good.
Know. The developer puts out a new GIF of the game every Friday, and it always shows a new feature every single Friday. He's done it for years. It's
wow,
so cool, bro.
Cool.
It's a tiny team.
Mm-hmm.
It's like him and like three others.
Whoa.
Do you think we'll get a reveal for the game then? Something's gonna happen? Maybe?
I don't know. He always says they're going to show more soon, and I don't really know.
It's called Sable,
oh,
Josh.
Here it is. Alpha.
I know. I've seen this.
Okay. This is old. Okay.
Well, I mean, this type. I don't really know.
Yeah, I'd say they probably still have a long time then.
It's just so cool. It looks awesome.
Oh, what is that? You can drive stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, it's so cute. All of that.
Art style is so cool.
Nice.
Josh is called Sable. Sable.
Little speed bike. Speeder.
Whoa. Ooh, that's new. That's new.
The bubble glide?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, she does have badass, that sleeve.
Badass tattoos.
What's that?
She is?
Can't tell if she's making a joke.
No, the song's in the game.
I'm not surprised.
Is that a Sheikah tattoo on her middle finger?
Yeah, it is.
That's awesome.
That's super sick. That's a good gaming tat.
Multi-level.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, it does cheese. I'll send you guys the dev. His name is Gregorius Keltha something. Keltha.
Kelthazar. No. Insane.
Gregorius Carethus.
Awesome. Here we go.
So
Sable.
Beautiful. Thank you, Michelle. Sable will be released on September 23rd. September 23rd. Year. I have some news for you. And to learn more about it's this happening. Amazing game, watch the Tribeca Game Showcase. That is tomorrow, where Sable was named an official selection of the Legendary Festival.
Wow.
Now, today is just the start of Summer Game Fest. Day of the Devs.
It's actually been so wow. many years.
It's happening.
Follow the live show today. And there are more events coming all weekend and all month, including the Xbox and Bethesda Game Showcase on
nice.
Sunday. It's going to be a good one. Right now, though, we're thrilled to announce the upcoming Western release of a spectacular
what?
3D massively multiplayer online role-playing
Lost
game.
Ark?
Welcome to the world of Lost Ark from Smilegate RPG and Amazon Games.
Amazon Games. Nice.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Amazon games.
I don't think Amazon had a hand in this until it was releasing on like how its Western release.
In the mouth.
Is now Megatron?
The Allspark. I don't have to watch any other show ever again just because I got Jurassic World Evolution 2.
So happy for you, Red. I really am.
You know, I love my survival, you know, build them ups.
Park manager.
Yeah, yeah, thank you. Park managers, yeah. Not survival.
For MMOs, for me, they never give me a reason to actually play them. Besides cool character design.
Yeah, yeah. Or good NPC design.
Yeah.
But there's never a reason to do it. It's funny.
No, I mean, it looks cool, but like, mm-hmm. I want to know what they're doing differently than another RPG. There's a million MMORPGs.
Mm-hmm. How many?
Oh! Ship action? Oh, that was cool. Oh wow! Fucking Smaug. Smaug.
Yeah, Final Fantasy 14 just surpassed World of Warcraft as
everybody's talking about it recently.
MMO RPG
with Everworld, their update.
Mm-hmm. I saw some footage of it. It's crazy how big it is. You know, like 50 people and attacking all the colors and stuff.
Which looks sick, but it probably takes 50, 60 hours to get to that point where you can do that.
Nice. That was cool.
Nice.
Sometimes when you play a game, there's that one thing in your inventory which turned out to be far more useful than you first realized. That's kind of like
Prime I would love to meet Jeff Keighley.
You're an Amazon Prime member, and most of you probably are, you get a ton of gaming goodies every month.
Oh.
This month, you can download Battlefield 4 and Batman the Telltale series.
Okay,
completely
cool
free for PC.
I just downloaded Battlefield 4. We should play it, guys, on PC. It'd be fun.
With Game Pass, I think we get, you get a lot of them. So.
It's awesome. That's true, too. You do have Game Pass.
This kickoff show would not have been possible without the Prime Gaming folks believing in my vision for a new way to bring you the news this summer. So, head over to gaming.amazon.com to check
commercial
out all
ads.
The perks and free games, which change every month, but you get to keep them forever.
Nice. Prime Gaming is great. They give you a lot of good
stuff.
It's
cool.
I get my accounts? Valorant gun buddies every month. I get my Destiny exotics every month.
I get GTA cash.
Even
though, like, I still redeem it even though I don't play that game.
I know.
Just keep adding up
just
the money.
Have it.
So much money waiting for me on there.
It'd be transfers to GTA 6. That'd be great. Now
that'd be cool though.
Let's see what they got for us.
GM of Call of Duty. It's so great to have you with us here on Kickoff Live. Everyone is
and they said they'd be skipping this.
I need zombies. A zombie map.
Looks like next week, June 17th, season 4.
Yes, we're super excited. We're super honored to be here. So thank you first and foremost to that. It's just such an amazing time for Call of Duty. We're experiencing such transformational growth and dynamism across the entire brand, you know, from premium title releases to everything
what a great word.
Today, with Warzone, with mobile, with esports. So it's just super incredible.
Esports
all the work and shout out to
forever going
to
grow.
Family who makes it happen every day.
Yeah, no, they debut trailers at the playoffs. Jeez, all the time. You know,
Rambo, Die Hard now.
It's like a movie premiere.
Season 4, but you guys, you know, continually update the game now with new stuff. Season 4 is coming next week. What can you, this is
zombies.
First info on it, so what can you tell the fans watching around the world?
Yeah, we're stoked. It's jam-packed with new content across Cold War and Warzone. You know, you've got new weapons, we've got new maps, we've got I'm super excited about the hijacked gulag. We've got expanded
hijacked gulag
for everybody who loves that
zombies gun. Okay,
you know, the gameplay experience. So we're thrilled, and I'm excited to bring it forward a little bit here today.
I know we've got the first look world premiere trailer of season 4.
Give me something good.
Let's take a look at that now.
Okay,
they do a really good job on these trailers. That's
here we go.
Just how it goes.
Copyrighted song too. No, oh, Hijack. I forgot.
I know. Hijack makes me want to play again, bro.
I completely forgot about it. And you get to leave. You understand? Like, their story's still continuing, though. That's kind of funny.
Yeah.
The sky is falling.
You know, I liked the campaign a lot in Cold War.
Oh, so good. Yeah. I enjoyed it. With, like, the open world aspect. The mystery. Okay. New maps.
Oh, Amsterdam.
Yes, Hijack! That's the seller right there.
Yeah.
Warzone breaks orbit. Oh, new location.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
Satellite crash.
So are we going to space for Warzone?
I know, right? Oh! Zombies in cage? Okay, yep. This is Outbreak. Outbreak mode, yep. I am death. Only strong remain. Okay, well, that was it. Nice. Oh my god, is that transit?
Oh my god, that looks so funny.
Stop. 1 week are you serious?
I don't know. It looked like the tunnel
to,
with the bus.
You first joined Activision to run esports, and we're going to talk a little bit now about what is the
classic
world series of
make a transit video off that shot, right? Or we'll get famous off that.
Yeah, true.
First of all, tell us what is World Series Warzone.
Yeah, we're super
the bus, right,
Cheesy?
The bus.
It's really a new way for us to highlight competitive Call of Duty. You know, we've got great success going with Call of Duty League, and now we've got some of the biggest names in gaming.
And now, 100 Thieves owner, Matt Haig, Nate Shot, Watson.
since it's launched, right? So we'll talk a little bit about what that entails, but custom lobby experiences, 150-player, two-a-side squad. So I'm stoked
they have
to
that
see
before?
How they kind of
rallied. I don't know if they updated that.
Yes, and coming up very soon, June 22nd,
okay.
Looks like Twitch Rivals is going to be a part of this.
Yeah, we are honored to be in partnership with Twitch, always, right? But certainly here with World Series of Warzone and partnering with Twitch Rivals, who's already done so much to really put competitive Warzone on display. So couldn't be in better partnership there.
Competitive
and,
Warzone.
Everybody tune in.
Yes.
That sounds like such a dated
thing, though,
statement.
That everyone has been talking about online, and that's who the captains are going to be for the structure of World Series of Warzone, at least for the first event.
Yeah.
I understand we've getting a little bit reveal here of who some of the captains are, right?
Yeah, we love the first five captains of the
Nate Shot.
like I said, these are huge.
The sixth screenshot.
Yeah. Oh, Tim.
Duty, and they also share our passion for competitive. Right? They really believe in the promise of World Series of Warzone and to really level up what it means to really battle it out. So couldn't be happier with some of these names, many of whom also hail from
That's cool. Yeah,
that is gonna be cool.
Branding in their faces like that.
Kind of takes the cake.
Yeah, it is cool. But Nate Shot has the best photo.
Because it's from his COD trailer where he's in it.
Oh, really?
So cool.
With the sniper.
Experience for everyone with so much more content, so we can't wait to see where you're going to take it. And I know there is a big new mainline game coming later this year too, right?
Indeed, indeed. More details to share later. New COD. On, but,
that's going to wow, lose. Confirmed. Yeah. You know, confirmed. This year we're getting another COD.
No, we're not. We're getting Battlefield.
There will come a time and a place for that. All right, Johanna, thank you.
Did they
so much
say that? And I just missed it.
All right, we've got lots of
new mainline COD.
But right now we've got a surprise guest joining us.
Surprise.
My fellow Canadian, Ryan Reynolds.
Hey, Ryan. What?
Whoa.
Thank you,
whoa.
Summer Game Fest. Now, I
trailer for free,
I know
free
what
guy?
Thinking, and no, I'm not here
definitely
to announce
it's free
I'm
guy.
The star of Elden Ring. I think. Instead, no, I'm making I'm telling you to talk about good old fashioned movies.
He said Elden Ring. Check
games?
Twitter.
He said Elden Ring. He said Elden Ring.
Check Twitter.
I have a new movie coming out.
That's exactly where I went. I'm going to see what Timur said.
In a popular open world video game.
Yeah, see, free guy. Free, it's a trailer.
Yep, here is Nibel, fellow Canadian Ryan Reynolds, just made an Elden Ring joke. Yep. Confirmed.
So fast.
Jeff Grubb, Elden Ring count, one.
It's first ever look at our cast on the big screen. This August.
Yeah, they just dropped a new trailer, I think, this morning.
The song said, if they announce Elden Ring at Summer Games Fest, I will defeat the Nameless King this weekend, and that's on Miyazaki.
My name is Guy.
Miyazaki!
This movie looks so fun. He said, let's make Grand Theft Auto a movie.
The idea of this movie is so cool, and I hate every single trailer.
Yeah.
But I love the idea of the movie. Copyright claim. There it is. We're done.
She's a gamer. Oh yeah, copyright claim.
She's
for
a
sure.
Gamer.
Keep talking, guys. Keep talking. Keep it up. Oh,
she's not like
in
other
this.
Girls.
What the heck?
Yes, he's an absolute troll.
Trolls exist. We can save.
Oh yeah.
We have to fight together.
What do they expect's gonna happen? They'll just survive. They'll just shut the game off. We'll all die.
I've seen a lot of this movie in the trailers.
Yeah, 100%. Oh my god, ninja!
Ninja? God.
All laser. What? Laser beam. Oh, Jack.
Jack?
Pokemane?
Pokemane?
Oh my god.
Terminate him.
Gamer
cameos. They try to make it more real with the gamers. Yeah. Oh.
Did you guys see Boss Level? With,
Boss Level?
Frank Grillo. It's a Hulu original movie, not a video
wait,
game.
It keeps coming
thing.
Back.
It was interesting.
I remember you told me about it. I heard it from you, man.
The guy, laser beam, all those guys who will be in Free Guy.
Jack's friends with.
I can't say it yet. All right. Up next,
Ryan Reynolds.
Multiple awards at the Game Awards, and Among Us just keeps going.
Remember when Elden Ring pre-orders opened? Shut the hell up.
Cheap ass gamer, pre-order Elden Ring PS4, Xbox One, $59.99 via Amazon Prime eligible.
Uh-oh, here we go.
Oh my god.
The best game on the planet Earth.
We're gonna get Elden Ring right now. At yeah, this.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
No way. Oh my god, this is crazy.
Remember we also said, if we get a Mario collab for Fortnite, $1,000 right there. I just noticed, Jesus said, why were they using HyperX headsets in the trailer?
Those guys.
Is that all they that's the sponsorship they had for the movie? That's what they had. Okay, it was just an ad.
Holy crap! Lord of the Rings gets anime film! Coming out this
cool.
year!
That's pretty fucking cool.
Wow.
Mask was available as a Twitch drop around the Game Awards, never to be seen again. In fact, I often hear on Twitter from people who get booted from games with the mask because folks think that they're hacked. Well, never fear, today.
Oh
the
my
mask
gosh.
Is back.
I think they're
a
hacked.
Lot of, a lot of Death Stranding love on the timeline right now.
Of Kickoff Live
cool.
to get your very own
oh,
Jeff Keighley mask.
I want that.
Once again, yeah. And it goes back into the vault. I don't know what's going on. All right. Speaking of independent developers, now I'm very happy to welcome to Summer Game Fest the head of indies at PlayStation, a legend in his own right who has some exciting things to share,
ooh.
Shuhei Yoshida. Hi, Shu.
Shuhei!
I don't know who this is.
Shuhei Yoshida.
What is he known for?
PlayStation indies.
Everything. The king of
talk about working with independent developers are the new and unexpected games that they create. Which allows us to offer an array of unique experiences for players. In my role as Sony, it's very exciting to get to meet with these talented studios, which sometimes can be one person or a small group of players.
Wow, just one person.
To help nurture the ideas and bring them to the PlayStation fans. One example.
Guys, I'm so excited for watching Summer Games Fest right now.
I know, I can't believe it's here already. This is all it?
E3?
To publish their new game, Chicory.
Part of me would like to be at a convention Chicory center though, screaming with people.
And
but,
give players a chance to experience a coloring book style world.
Aww.
Where players use their painting powers.
Painting games are always classic.
Puzzles, make friends, and draw.
This actually looks really cool.
Check out Chicory: A Colorful Tale on PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 after the show. As a huge Soulspawn games fan, I totally enjoy the beautiful 2D action adventure Salt and Sanctuary a few years ago.
So he's with Sony?
The developer Ska Studios has been hard at work on a new title, which I'm proud to present to you.
Oh.
Salt and Sacrifice.
Sword and Sacrifice? I don't know.
Not Elden Ring.
Not oh so I'm just gonna get hype for Elden Ring because of you, man. Catch up with us. I see it. No! Reindeer! My reindeer, no! Jeez, is this your kind of game? You're real hype for it.
I
was given
a second chance. I love that level up screen. Like this.
Oh yeah, reminds me of Valheim.
It's basic but yet super in depth.
Yeah.
This looks really cool. Only to hunt mages. But it also looks like one of those flash games you would play.
It looks like Miniclip. I was gonna say it, but I didn't want to disrespect the game.
No. Yeah.
I hope all three of us get a win this show. Like there's something we all wanted.
I've already got a win. I'm just having a good time.
Okay.
I'm just
time. My win was Jurassic World. You know what I mean? Like I'm satisfied. Salt, not sword.
James hanging salt. On by a thread for a Bloodborne 2 announcement.
He's still hanging, dog. I've been hanging since like 2019. To share with you a brand new trailer
from the upcoming Annapurna and Heart Machine. Oh, Annapurna's great. Solar Ash, which is coming to
PlayStation later this year. Like oh, not the one I was expecting. I want that overhead down Willem Dafoe Annapurna game. That's what I'm waiting for.
12 minutes,
thank you.
People are saying it's gonna come up in Microsoft.
Ooh, okay.
This is the Hyperlight Drifter devs.
We only got a publisher. I don't think. Did we get a studio?
No, I don't think so. No.
Annapurna.
Oh, that's a publisher.
It was Games Beat or whatever it was. It just showed on screen. I forgot.
Okay,
it was like a heart.
Shit.
Whoa.
Looks cool.
This is really cool.
Oh.
A huge Shadow Colossus inspiration.
Yeah.
Have you ever played
It's trippy.
Edith. What happens with Edith Finch? You all ever played that
I
game?
Haven't.
What Remains of Edith Finch? Yeah,
What Remains, thank you. That's a great game. It's all story based.
Never played it.
It's like a 30-minute game, but phenomenal story. Phenomenal.
Okay. Heart Machine.
Oh, sick.
What was that date?
So great. Can't wait to see it later this year. Now, this week, there's a ton of video game news, but there's also a big game launching across console and PC, Chivalry 2, which brings
64-player
multiplayer medieval battles to life. Sledgehammers, swords, axes, you name it.
It looks awesome. I just don't know if I'd, like, love it.
I feel like I've seen recent buzz on that. For Chivalry 2,
which you can play right now. First-person medieval slashing, dog.
Also third
person. It was on the Game Pass, I think. That's okay. I was gonna download
it on,
this.
It's on Game Pass?
Yeah, it was on Game Pass, and I was like,
no
I download
way.
This? Yeah, and I was like, nah, I won't.
Oh, hell to play it all with you if we get on Game Pass.
Okay. Because I was like, I have Assassin's Creed Valhalla I gotta finish first before I get to this.
This is just like multiplayer.
Yeah, I'm down to
it.
Yeah,
it's not an RPG.
Ridiculous.
Yeah, see, it's crazy. This looks fun, though. massive battles.
It looks like super detailed everything. It's like, I don't know how this is going to run on my computer.
I know, right? The RAM can't handle all those NPCs in the back.
It's a lot.
Oh! Ooh. Decapitations. Oh, yes! For Agatha! Agatha Harkness! 64 player, wow. Wild. Absolutely exhilarating. Oh, you can catapult a guy?
The first one felt like it just came out. They just busted out the second one. They're like, the first one did
came
okay.
Out a long time ago.
I know, but it feels because I don't hear anything about it since the last time.
Next Monday, June 14th, Prime Gaming members will get an exclusive player card to celebrate the 1 year anniversary and a pity party spray through June 25th.
Pity party.
This is all leading up to the release of episode 3 of the game later this month.
Yes, sir.
We celebrated with an epic WW Fest unlocked year one stream on June 25th. But there will also be a new agent. Who could it be? Well, here's your first very, very exclusive, but very, very quick tease.
Uh-oh.
Whet your appetite.
It's a tease.
More to be revealed later this month during Summer Game Fest.
Nice. Boom, 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 boom. This is Val? This is Valorant? Is that what you're saying or no?
Valorant, baby.
Okay.
That's it? Okay, awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, warring PMC factions face off against each other in Escape from Tarkov.
SMH.
Oh, Escape from Tarkov. I heard this is getting talked about.
Today, I have Tarkov. New look at the it's crazy.
It costs money, right? I've been hesitant to buy it.
Boom, 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 boom. They'll show a new trailer for that agent like next week or like the day before the season comes out. Tarkov's just hella hardcore. There's.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. Insane. No HUD or anything, item management full.
Yeah.
You die, you lose everything, even the guns that you've built up over months.
I'm not down for that sweat.
But you know what I do? I just keep replaying it. Mm-hmm. Like, you start with a pistol and just see how much you can get, and I just keep loading up all my stuff.
And then do you dive and lose it all?
No, I don't. I never bring in anything I collect into the game.
Oh, okay.
I leave it at the hideout and I go out with a pistol every time.
So do you have to go to like a dropout zone to exit with all your stuff, right? Okay.
Like an extraction.
But that's all it is? Just getting loot and just keep running it back over and over again?
There's more to it, but I haven't done anything more. I really haven't played too much of it.
Seems super stressful.
It's so stressful. Like, this is scarier than a horror game because you have everything's on the line, bro.
Yeah. Like I've seen videos of you can hear footsteps and stuff. And you're just there waiting like somebody there.
You can't take anything with you. You leave it all on the line.
You can't take it with you. It's all dark.
Also, this game has
a lot
like
of
this
reloading.
Thick film grain in it. It's like, it feels like so grimy when you play it. It's crazy.
Still reloading, just putting everything.
Just a lot of reloading. Take a shot every time they reload in this trailer. Environmental destruction, that's cool. Oh, that dude has been playing this game for 12 years and he just murdered him. Lost everything. I almost feel empathy for these people.
Played for 12 years. Oh my god. My whole life gone in an instant. That's so sad. Oh, man.
That guy's 7-month account just got ended in this trailer. He's still crying about it.
By some 12-year-old who pulled up in a fucking tank.
Let's get this guy. Is it?
He's there on his computer crying. Just doing his shake.
That's funny.
I was a kid, the simulation games of Peter Molyneux were some of my favorites.
Peter Molyneux?
On the fries and the theme park
that's the name I haven't heard in a while.
Was so devilish. Well, many of the team members behind those games went on to create 2 Point Studios and 2 Point Hospital. Well,
Today, we're excited to
share
the first trailer for their next two-point simulation, Two-Point Campus.
Two-Point Campus?
That first sight of the school gates.
Oh, they did the hospital one, right?
Yeah. And they also did this game called, like, Goddess or whatever.
Okay, interesting.
They do, like, social experiment games, too.
Okay. Wow. Hilarious.
Education has to be fun.
Has to be fun. Cool.
Apparently, the results speak for themselves. Academia has never been more appealing. More
academia.
More whatever this is. Today's campus is a place to live and a place to learn. Finely crafted by the sharpest minds that money can buy. Though sometimes you still can't get the staff.
Oh. People are really excited about that Death Stranding announcement.
It's the box, direct, man. I think it's that callback. We're like, oh.
This one says, it'll take me months to recover from Kojima's Metal Gear debate. Also from Tamori says, I can feel it in my bones. The Elden Ring.
It's coming. It'll happen.
Dude,
huge odds that it's going to happen? Are we going to get it? There's huge odds. No. Oh, you said it's
Jeff Keighley says, pro tip, you won't want to miss the grand finale.
Maybe the grand finale. It's Elden Ring. That's a big thing, yeah. He said endgame. Oh. He did say there's an endgame.
I can't wait
thing.
To see Tamor on Twitter.
What?
This year, I am
Tamor on Twitter has been talking about Elden.
They have been doing an incredible job adapting games with series like Castlevania and the anime.
Xbox only has a 90-minute conference on Sunday.
You don't have to wait long to find out more.
They got to split something.
I'm honored to be guest hosting Netflix's Geeked Week
live. Geeked Week.
Mario Takahashi and
it's tomorrow.
You can expect the first clip of the Cuphead show.
Cuphead show.
This show is give me Cowboy Bebop.
Sensation. What the heck?
There are a few guarantees in life. Death Taxes and Jeff Keighley telling us he's from Canada in any showcase he hosts.
We might also have updates on The Witcher and the live-action Resident Evil series.
Geeked Week is I've been wanting to see this. The cast is great for that show. Here's a little sneak peek. Resident Evil.
Yeah, cheese. That's what I heard, dog.
Oh, here we go.
Please, please, please.
Oh my gosh, Raul!
Yeah, he's great.
Holy dude, love that guy. He's always posting photos of him doing models.
Castlevania.
And I relate to that. Movies.
Okay.
Splinter Cell. Cobra Kai! Oh, I'm watching it now! Are you kidding me?
Castlevania.
Witcher? Umbrella Academy? Oh my god. That's
I'm looking
a
for a
show.
Single shot.
Oh my god, it's such
no
a good
Cowboy
show.
Bebop. There's so
much to get geeked Cowboy about. Cowboy Bebop. I'm sorry.
So much to get.
Smite.
Just yet though, coming up next
Smite.
Smite, a cross-play cross-platform game that continues to do some pretty amazing IP crossovers. You may remember last summer we announced the Avatar the Last
Yeah, Master of the Universe new animated show.
Well,
I never
as Smite
about
enters
that.
Its ninth year, it's time to go upside down.
Ooh.
Interesting.
Yeah, the new game? New game from them?
No,
it's gonna be another app,
IP
probably.
Crossover. So they're gonna put in one of the characters from Stranger Things as a god.
Demogorgon.
Yeah.
They were just talking about this yesterday or this morning.
There's been a lot of Stranger Things news this week.
Yeah, this okay, this was telekinesis.
I remember how special that first season was of Stranger Things. Yeah.
Getting weird now. It's getting real weird.
Oh, it's.
Wow.
Both of them.
Demogorgon.
Okay.
Bakasora.
Ooh, Star Court 11.
Oh, she's a. They're skins. Those two guns are skins.
They're all skins.
For like that character, Slavanus. Apollo.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool.
Hopper.
Cool skins.
Nice.
Next up, we announce a lot of games on my shows. I think this is the first time we
That's
are
true,
announcing
cheesy.
An entirely new game label, new game publisher.
I was
Enjoy
say
this
movie.
First look at more than 12
game
games
labels.
That make up its initial slate.
Oh, wow. This is awesome. This is huge.
Oh. Yeah, this is huge.
Whoa. Sometimes
I oh. Returnal looks like a Returnal.
What it all means.
I know it's new. Let's begin. Oh, whoa.
Japanese developer?
Yeah.
Oh, whoa. That looks huge. These look like AAA style games, man.
Yeah.
It's like huge. Payday. Payday. Oh, that was cool. Ooh, ooh.
That medieval one looks really sick.
Mm-hmm. Dude, these little games are already out. Okay.
That looks like a turn-based game. You know, medieval. The ship? What was that ship one?
I know.
Just Payday. That's familiar.
I assume these are all games that are already out.
Makes me who I am.
You might be right, James. These might all be out. What's the guy with Payday. The robot face?
There's a guy with a mask. That's a gamer. Yeah. Payday.
Yeah, yeah, I know the Payday. Yeah. I don't know any of the other ones.
I don't know.
Like that one. What's one with the bloody teeth?
What's your name? Blast.
For the last.
Outward. Stars above.
Scars above.
Oh, scars.
Oh, Kingdom Come. That's all it was.
Crossfire.
Crossfire Legion. Iron Harvest. Ultra Blade 2. King's Bounty 2.
So name fucking four.
That's the one I was thinking of, Final Form, I guess.
Prime Matter. That's their big one. Prime Matter. Oh.
Prime Matter.
I don't know why.
Sweet logo.
Yeah.
I like it.
That's cool.
There you have it.
Prime Gun Grave is back. That's something already. Okay.
And there's actually one more game added to the mix. And for that, we go to Todd Hollinshead from Saber. Ooh. Todd, how you doing?
Special.
I'm great, Jeff. Thank you for the intro there.
Keep calm and respawn.
Oh, look at his little bus. Last edition, Mando.
Which is Mandalorian. That Saber and Prime Matter are working together on a new game in the Painkiller franchise.
Painkiller. Painkiller?
Well, fun.
All right, very cool on that. And there are more details on Prime Matter coming tomorrow with a stream at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern, and I will be stopping by. Next up is a brand new IP from a brand new studio, Stray Bombay. Okay. It's coming this fall only to Xbox, PC, and Game Pass on day one. It's called The Anacrusis, a four-player cooperative first-person shooter set aboard a massive starship stranded at the edge of explored space.
Whoa, that
sounds like an awesome Game Pass game if it's co-op. Yeah.
Against alien hordes to unlock perks, weapons.
I want to hear one of these guys one day say exclusive to Xbox, PC, and PS5. Like, that's all of them. That's all the consoles. Exclusive to everything.
Hello?
This is going to have,
Destiny site.
Whoa. Yeah, yeah.
It was a Destiny ass site.
Oh god, it's hordes.
Oh, yeah, it's zombies.
Space zombies.
It's literally space zombies, yeah. Look at the way they run. They look like people in suits.
I like that little pistol.
Little pea shooter.
This is not good. Not good.
This looks a little early. Little early.
Yeah.
It's probably like alpha footage.
Oh. I already know. I can
looks like
Vincent
it could
though.
Be a lot of fun in co-op. I'm not gonna lie.
Vincent starts to get swarmed. Guys, I'm scared. There's so many. Ah.
We call them tanks. Sounds about right.
I call them brutes.
Jeezy, well, that's probably why they would say it then. They would exclude the Switch. I forgot about
What's up, Ashton?
Oh, some cool.
Wait, Ashton? Is this the Ashton?
Awesome look.
What's good, dude?
Yeah, it does look similar to Left 4 Dead 2. I was thinking the same thing.
Back for Blood. When do we get that?
It's coming out. New World, the colonialism game.
Set on the supernatural island of Aeternum. It's finally coming out later this summer, and in the deep dive video, game director Scott Lang will take players
Scott
into a mysterious supernatural island that is a world of wonder and horror.
Let's see.
Whoa.
Let's see.
It's up to you to
unite warring human factions. I'm doing great, Ashton. Thanks for asking, bro. Hope your day is going well. Wants to unmake
life. Scott and the team will detail updates to the game, including new mid and end game content, more PvE and
expeditions, five-player challenges with you hunt native people, bosses, loot, and more.
Six of these expeditions will be at
launch. Yeah.
Is the game already out? July
20th, no. Public
launch this game's kind of canceled. 31st.
I will not gonna be canceled. Down at the studio to
chat with Scott about you play as colonialism hunting and past year people down and...
No, it got under some hot water because
and visit game
studios again. I miss all these developers. Yeah.
So check out the special deep dive stream on New World tomorrow at 8 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Eastern at
I'm actually interested to watch that.
All right, well,
I'll be after it's out. Or a summary of it. With
Fast and Furious. Bring some of the Fast and Furious into the game. The greatest game.
They are back with a twist that is
Rocket League?
Rocket League with Fast 9, the next installment of the Fast saga arriving in US theaters June 25th.
Nice.
Psyonix is
got my can't wait.
Got my tickets already.
Charger, I wish I could go with you guys.
Yeah, it would be fun.
Supersonic acrobatic rocket powered
I was playing Rocket League last night with my cousins for like 4 hours.
Pontiac. Damn. Fun.
Pretty fun to be back in it.
Enjoy Rocket
Pontiac. Oh. Yeah. Family. We can fly because of family.
Pretty awesome.
Oh, yes. Those cars look sick. Oh, there it is. The classic. Oh, that's so awesome. The rocket car. I know. Copyright. Nice. Love it. Dang, the Charger looks so cool.
Cool.
Nice. Dropping money on that. No.
Strap a rocket engine to a car and play soccer seems like the right idea to me. The Fast and Furious 3-car bundle arrives
so too,
June 17th in Rocket League.
Okay, Jeff is just out here killing it, man. I'm so happy for him. Released a
teaser for their first unnamed multiplayer. They're half people, half shark.
No, that's the studio. The studio is called Shark.
Oh, they okay. I don't know why. She had teeth. He has a fin. I don't know. I was real confused
what?
There. I don't know why I look like they were shark people. That's hilarious.
Oh god.
Slino, say it. You saw it too, man. You saw it too.
I didn't see it. I'm
just
sorry.
A red part of his arm.
For centuries we have lived in secrecy. We got a lot. We got Wonderlands. Some COD stuff. Masquerade. New DLC for what was that game? Alright, Director's Cut. There's been
that's
a lot of games, Ashton. A lot of games. People I know. Death Stranding, thank you. Among you. Until now. Whoa.
Gives me vampire prototype energy off of this.
Oh, yeah.
A little more. Okay, not
join
really.
The
but
blood
maybe a tiny bit.
It kind of gives me Dying Light vibes, maybe, with the rooftop parkour.
Is this the vampire
this
one?
Is. I think, nice yeah, it's powers. Definitely a vampire. Something.
Vampire? Wasn't that a game? No, that already came out.
Yeah,
Vampire
yeah, that's out. Game.
I think we saw the review
shark
for that
people.
One. I know, I thought it was shark people. Look at her, it was the mohawk. It was the mohawk that girl has. And that other girl had teeth, and I was like,
oh, God.
Oh, okay, shark people.
Everybody has teeth.
I know, but like fangs, I mean, like, you know, sharp.
That was classic. There was no sharks anywhere.
Yeah, there was no sharks anywhere.
Vampire and the Masquerade Bloodlines blood is going to be sick.
Oh, okay,
Vampire
cool.
and Masquerade
Bloodlines.
Oh, yeah, you already knew.
Blood Hunt. Nice.
Ashton, you're already on that.
Play this game wow. And we actually nice. Won't have to wait long. You can sign up now.
Next week.
Bloodhunt.com is where you go for the closed alpha PC test available on July 2nd. Blood Hunt will be released later this year. Next, the latest horror game series from the creators of Until Dawn continues with the House of Ashes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Never mind. Anthology. The Dark Pictures Anthology. I don't know why I was here.
American
yeah.
Iraqi soldiers stranded in a cursed temple. Here's the story.
Yeah, this is a really cool
cursed temple.
It's a great concept, but that last game was boring. It was really it wasn't it.
Okay.
Man. The first one was
I
great.
Watched,
the second one I did with my buddy co-op, and it was. God, it was so slow, man. It was like 3 hours of nothing. No story. It wasn't that. It was alright. But this new one looks funny. Has awoken from its slumber. It was a curator. For
blood. Curator. Yes. See how many have fallen into shadow. Right, are you in like a New Hope? Cheesy's asking.
New Hope. Yeah, I don't think a New Hope. I didn't like that one. The first one I did, though, with the boat. The boat? The ship one was fun.
Need
descend. Yeah, Man of Medan was fun. Not New Hope. Extremely brave.
Men out to hold fire.
Or extremely foolish.
We're gonna sigh out this shit.
Brothers in arms, or will it be a case?
Yeah, yeah, Little Hope. Each
man for that was an actual himself. Quote. We're gonna psyops this shit.
We're gonna psyops.
You teeter on the edge of an abyss.
It's so silly. I love it.
The
choices you make determine the game.
Guiding you through the unknown.
I want to see John Bernthal in this.
I tell you what.
He would.
Bat.
Their lights.
You're ahead.
Oh god.
Unless you can find the means.
Oh, predator?
Beneath the earth. Swallowed.
You have to move, let's go.
By the void. Will you find the path to salvation? Or be lost in the darkness?
It's a big thing.
Big dude. Oh, even made the clicks. The predator.
Ash is October 21st.
Oh, that's what they are. Okay. Oh, wow. Cheesy. Another collectible. You get October 22nd. Gosh.
They're busting out one of those year, aren't they? Most
beloved JRPG. That's even
because they're kind of shorter, yeah.
They're cool. Short.
Good for them.
Well,
the latest game on Switch right now.
2 years ago, and it brings the franchise into stunning 3D with Unreal Engine 4. Here's a world premiere look at the latest trailer with more information following
Unreal?
In the coming weeks.
Anything Unreal, and I'm there. Oh, what is this?
Writer's like, never mind, it's anime.
Shut up.
Writer's like, I take it back.
Never mind. Bandai.
Any fancy place they got here? Harmony and coexistence between the Renans and the Danans.
The Renans so funny. And the Danans.
Anything anime, I'm out. No.
Dude, Scarlet Nexus demo was so freaking cool, dude. Did you play really the demo, cool. Cheesy?
I'm Captain Kisara of the Elder Menencia Guard.
Captain Kisara, hello there.
Which character did you play as Finn for the
Scarlet Nexus demo? The
dude. I play as both. This crew just gets bigger and bigger. I like the dude a little more.
Do they have different powers? Cool.
Completely different.
Was it a different game?
Play style.
Or was it a different,
different
like section?
Area, different.
What?
Different yeah.
I'm so dumb. I should have played the other one.
Oh,
you
man.
Still can.
This is Tenet's realm.
Is it over? It's only just begun.
Dudes with long ass swords.
I know, right?
I love
heavier
it. Get
than
it
them.
Done.
Tales like, of Arise. Oh, my foot.
Number 10th.
Oh.
Le Petit Prince.
Le Petit Prince.
Le Petit.
I just noticed that. That's funny. So, what's Breath of the Wild 2? That's the big game next? I mean, from Nintendo.
For Nintendo.
But yeah. I'm saying, like,
Summer
that's.
Game Fest, we have a special announcement for you. At the console version of Sky Children of the Light.
That's like a big one, though, right? Breath of the Wild 2?
No. On June. Yeah.
Freaking
huge. Huge, yeah.
Okay. And the Little huge. Prince season would start soon after on July 6th.
Enjoy this looks cute.
I'm gonna take a quick break. I'll be right. 30 seconds.
Le Petit Prince.
One of the things
another world premiere.
I'd say like July 6th.
This show to introduce you to new developers or 11th.
Studios with games that deserve the spotlight. That's definitely the case with this next title from a small Swedish studio named Wishfully. Planet of Lana tells the story of a young girl and her loyal friend who embark on a mission through a colorful world that's designed to feel like a gouache watercolor painting come to life. Here's your first look at the Planet of Lana, coming to Xbox and PC in 2022.
You love this book? Wait, what book is it, Sly? For this world premiere, is it a game based off the
wonderful.
Book?
Did they say anything about this one?
Oh, The Little Prince is the book. Got it.
Right. This looks like a 2D side scroller.
I'm gonna have a good one. All right, see you, Josh.
Hey, Josh.
Oh, bye, man.
Peace out. Thanks for hanging out.
Let's hit that. A little chunk. A little chunky thing. I want to poke it. Poke its belly.
I like this.
Whoa, those things coming in. War. War never changes.
No, Ashton.
That was cool. Wait, was there Warhammer?
No.
Actually?
No.
Okay, not yet then.
Whoa. Nice. This gives me like Ori. Ori vibes. Will of the Wisp.
Yeah. Huge Ori.
Frick, I already know this is going to be one of those ones where I have the soundtrack just all the time.
Well, yeah, Ori's fun. A little bit of it.
Did they say this was Xbox exclusive?
No, they didn't say anything regarding platform.
That's cool.
That looks awesome.
2022.
Yep, that looks really dope. Good. I'm in.
Yeah.
Wishlist it now.
Oh, Steam only.
Oh, Xbox 2. That's cool.
Oh, it is Xbox. Okay. All right, Game Pass then, baby.
World premiere. Oh.
What a beautiful
Overwatch.
Honored to have that on our show.
Well, here's the co-op guy that had the most.
The game director of Overwatch 2, Aaron.
Surprised you guys didn't freak out on this.
Thank you so much.
It's already announced.
Oh, it's been okay.
We are excited to learn more about what's planned for Overwatch 2. You guys recently, you had a PvP live stream that I watched, and you revealed some changes coming to Overwatch 2. What can you tell us? What's the latest?
Yeah.
Does it feel like a sequel, or is it just kind of like a reskin of the same?
Overwatch 2's format has changed.
Have they been updating it?
It's a sequel.
This requires a fresh look at all of our heroes in the game. It should feel new yet familiar to fans of our strategic team-based combat.
Yeah, it was great to see you guys playing, and you know, I long awaited for people to get a chance to go hands-on with it. And today, I know you brought us a look at some skins for some of the characters, right?
Mm. Yeah, the team is so passionate about updating the look and the feel.
That means they're not ready to show the game yet, dude.
And one aspect of that is
been a while.
Entirely new models.
I feel like this game is gonna be like Destiny 2 and survive for the next 10, 20 years.
So today we're going to be looking at two of those.
A long time, just updating it and updating it.
All right, well. Let's take a look here, and I know you can tell us a little bit about what we're seeing, but 2024.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, what do we got here?
Yeah, so this is Baptiste. And there's a lot of new technology that go into our models. We have new hair shader tech, excuse me, in order to get the look that we're going for with his haircut.
That's he also so has funny, he flipped that.
Cape
share hater, hair shader.
Give that medic or surgeon vibe to
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
I am excited for Overwatch 2, bro.
Yep, so next up is Sombra. This was a very challenging look for us to update. It's an asymmetrical design. There's so many layers of hair and clothing and technology in this. If you look closely, you can actually see circuitry and nodes embedded in her clothing. She's a world-class hacker, so it all makes sense.
No, again, it's, you know,
right. Great for fans. That's it. Just makes sense.
Yeah.
The
it
first
fits.
Game updated for two. Overwatch 2, and
it's
we
kind
can't
of a
wait to see
funny logo.
More on the game.
Didn't have much to do there.
Little sneak preview here, and I'm sure there'll be more later this year on Overwatch 2.
I don't mean a lot.
You bet. Thank you.
Awesome. Simple. All right. Thanks very much, Aaron. Now, recently I had a chance to play Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance with the game developer Jeff Haddam, Hannibal Buress, and Ember Moon from the WWE. That's right. You didn't expect me to say that. But this game is a ton of fun, and it's coming to Game Pass on June 22nd. Take a look.
D&D.
Hey guys, it's Jeff Keighley,
it's
and today as part of Summer Game Fest, we are going hands-on with a game that is coming out in just
This
is a quiet trailer that he gave.
Yeah.
We've got Jeff, one of the game developers from 2K, Jeff. Special guest,
Hannibal
Buress.
Whoa, this looks so cool. Great.
Okay. Oh, that looks like a trap.
Oh,
that looks like a trap.
Oh, my God. Traps.
I love when they get personalities to play games and they're just like, oh, no, I've never played a game in my life. A warrior's death,
I died again. I'm coming to get you.
Hey.
Watch it.
I was like, how much money did they pay him? Or what are they promoting?
Dude, this is the, like, the font. The Dungeons & Dragons font is so...
Absolutely. I've read all the books, especially the Driss backstory. I just connected with...
Have you guys ever played a campaign of D&D or something? Major character?
Hell yeah. So much fun, man.
It's a lot of fun.
The red eyes, even though Driss has purple, I just love everything about him, that he's just constantly the good guy the entire time.
Oh! Oh! What the?
Butcher, the big chef.
Ah, that doesn't look healthy at all. Why did I just run up on him?
Let me see what you got.
That's cool.
No, this looks fun. I don't really know what it's like, but this does not look very good. I just don't know if it's like a story or like how that works.
True. Oh my god. Wow. It still has a thumbs up.
That was great.
The chef.
June 22nd.
Wow, that comes out very soon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Paladins.
I can't believe Paladins is coming back. This is like, this is big for some people.
Yeah. This was their Overwatch, right?
It is. It looks just free, like... Overwatch. Yeah, no, Paragon. That's what I'm thinking. Yeah, Paragon's coming back also.
Is Paragon coming back?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Genlock.
Oh, Rooster Teeth?
Yeah.
Nice.
All right, Summer Game Fest kickoff live presented by Prime Gaming continues. Yesterday was an amazing tease.
See, 2-hour event. That's my guess.
Okay.
And if you want to dust up on the history of the franchise, its last big modern day game, that was Battlefield 4. It's this month. Prime Gaming members get to download it and play it for free through June 20th. Yep. Now, there's no catch. This is the full blown PC version of the 2013 game. And
I'm gonna have to download that. That's huge.
I know. I redeemed it, but I kind of want to play a little bit. Right now.
Gene Park tweeted out, "This MF said sure." Here's the game showcase for the first gameplay
footage of Battlefield 2042.
Gonna be really cool. Let's go.
Three days.
Look at another world premiere. Monster Hunter Stories is coming to the Switch in July.
Monster Hunter.
Got your first look at the story trailer.
Nice.
Dude, the guy that made Sable, he said, "Just realized we announced a release date. Time for a beer, I think."
Epic. God, I love Monster Hunter.
Wings of Ruin. Wings of Ruin. I don't understand. That Rathalos is... Capcom.
The dialogue in these games is always just so throwaway. It's incredible.
So throwaway. God.
In the actual Monster Hunter games, I don't know how good it is in stories, but...
And this is the Monster Hunter that the movie was based off of?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
There's only one.
Mm-hmm. We can't let there's, but there's multiples. Hunter. Are they multiple Monster Hunter games though? But
yeah, there's tons.
Okay.
Tons.
The newest one's it's Rise. Just based off the franchise. It's not based off the one.
Yeah, new game.
Because I don't know why there was this one game that looked more like realistic than this cartoon style.
Yeah. No, Ryder, you're right. You're right. I don't know why, James. Why are you shaking your head? Weird.
Because it's not one specific game. The movies based off of.
No, but he's saying about the art style.
Yeah, I was just saying in general. I was confused with this. Okay. I've never seen like this style with Monster Hunter.
I see.
It's like weird.
So I see. You're going to be born, huh?
Oh, nice.
Is there a release date?
Shorter. Oh.
Those sticker sets look like Twitch emotes.
Oh, what'd you get? Oh, amiibo things cool.
From Software just updated their YouTube with a new trailer for Elden Ring. Shut up, cheese.
Shut the front door.
Shut up.
Hilarious. Updated.
We're not getting Elden Ring. Legendary rock band hits
the road this summer on the Hella Mega Tour with Green Day and Fallout Boy. Here we go.
But first, they came together with an indie developer to create
stream. And now it's gone?
For the community. Yes, you can co-stream this performance. So turn it
what
up.
What does it mean, co-stream? New, like it's not going to get copyrighted?
Song, yeah, that's what he's saying.
From Wave Break, this is
Weezer. Oh, it's not live?
The music video.
No. Oh, they.
Oh,
they,
nope.
Yeah,
did
they,
you know? Stayed.
It's so old.
So weird. Like, it not being live takes it away from me.
It's animals.
Weezer's great, but why are it live?
This game they're showing while they do this.
I know, it doesn't fit at all.
The Weezer symbols. Oh, God.
Like that they have that little teddy bear face.
Look, they even have like a little heads up display on the bottom right. It's a gun with 97 like health and bullets.
Yeah, I just saw. Yeah, what is that?
There it is. It's back. It's
yeah,
back.
67. What the heck? I remember watching Green Day at last year's game. Game Awards. They're so good.
I played this game. I feel like this is gonna be a platinum.
You played this game? You know what this game was?
Oh, no, I said I would.
Oh.
A Weezer game?
Yeah.
Weezer
game. Oh, look at this. Their album cover. How funny.
Oh, it's their characters. Got it.
What is this now, dude? It's their performance. It's so random, right? Oh. Oh my god, I just noticed your face, James. Pure shock right now. Oh man,
I've just been sitting like this for the past like 3 minutes. This is so
bad.
He's
got a blazer and a gun like he's a gangster, bro.
Fucking A.
That's so funny.
Low key, that game looks epic. What's up, Julian? How's it going, bro? We're all in.
Jeff, how are you doing? Kojima, it's absolutely fucked here, mate.
We're still on lockdown. The world's over. Oh, we got Tro. Tro himself.
The singer works at my local library.
What's up, Tro?
You know what I'm wondering? I wonder if I could have live streamed this to YouTube and then it just uploads there from there. I just realized that now.
It would have.
I could have done that.
Yeah.
Instead of recording. That way, no one's going to anybody on the YouTube channel.
World premiere, Hideo Kojima goes to therapy.
Oh my god.
I love bad trailers for good RPGs. Ryder, that's a great idea though. We should do that.
We should have done that. Because it just posts straight to it. For the next events, I can stream it to
YouTube.
Yeah. You do Twitch.
Good idea.
Platforms, Twitch soundtrack, and a limited edition 7-inch vinyl on
iMovie. Oh, wow.
Right, we'll have to make an affiliate. Right now, let's turn that breaks to our affiliate contract, but that's fine. We can do it. We'll do it.
Yeah.
He showed a brief glimpse of gameplay in December and
fans
wanted more. All right, back to the show.
Okay.
I'm so sweaty right now. Oh my god.
Dude, you look like you have five layers on, man.
Maybe you're right, Cheese. I gotta brush up on my terms of service.
You're wearing a hoodie and the flannel over the hoodie.
But it doesn't, like, add much.
Work better on certain monsters. Learn it or die.
I bet you have two shirts under that hoodie, don't you?
I don't have any shirt under this hoodie.
Oh, okay.
Feels good on the nips, huh?
Rule number two.
Oh, I know.
Every time I wear my hoodies,
except
I take
I haven't
off.
Worn a shirt under a hoodie since 2012.
Oh my god.
Really?
No, I'm saying that's what you're saying.
Oh, I always wear a shirt under my hoodie.
Really?
Wow. Normally I do, but in the mornings like I don't.
I go just hoodies, and then I take them off, and my skin's all like sticky with like acne. I think the inside creates like a chamber. It's so weird. I don't know.
You gotta wash your sweatshirts.
I wash them. They're so clean, dude. You don't know.
What the heck?
I take them off and it's always like weird textures all over my body.
I know this game looks really good. And rule number
four. Well, you guys are like, oh, dirty sweatshirts.
Oh, sure. Here, yeah.
You won't, mate.
You're freaking out, chat.
Look at those shoulder things. Giant balls.
Oh, it's free. Oh, that's gonna be a free game.
That was weird. Sega. What?
Game I really can't wait for is Dying Light 2. Yes, sir, man. It's happening. We got a video on that up on the channel. A ton of fun. Well, later today, the team and Rift Apart tonight. Will be doing a special launch
stream on Twitch and to tell us that more, fucking gun, then. Marcus and Mike. The void gun.
Marcus and Mike.
Hey, Jeff. In the game.
Insomniac.
Kick off live. Marcus Smith here, creative
fake background.
Insomniac Games.
Yeah. Rift Apart. Fake background.
We're still excited funny. That players finally get a chance to play.
Nice emote intro.
And celebrate. Want to spend some more time.
No way.
At 2 p.m. Pacific.
This game looks
Eastern,
so fucking good.
Vincent, how do you know who that is?
I don't know who that is. Right, Mike? He's just a doctor, bro. I don't know.
Wait, that's crazy. He was the guy who cuts my lawn.
Dude, that guy's my plumber, bro.
Oh, he's also my babysitter.
He was my professor. He was my professor last semester. That's so hilarious.
50-50 for shit under the hoodie.
We'll see you there.
Oh!
Jesus, okay. did yours arrive? I'm gonna wait for a sale. I've made my decision. Right, James, help me make my decision.
When does Rift Apart release?
If you pre-order, you get the gun that teleports things in from other PlayStation games.
you have to be able to get that another way.
They came to me with this phenomenal idea. Proposed that I play Anton Castillo. The leader of Young,
God, I love this guy.
Big vision and
Giancarlo
for his country.
Esposito.
And it really appealed to me.
It is house. So sick.
First came from a love of his really family cool. And a love of his community
bike.
And country. And it was so in line.
This
with
is good.
Going on
all we need is him in Marvel, and he's in every franchise.
Breaking what a great opportunity.
The other part I don't want him in Marvel.
Just a different technology.
He's gonna be he's so oversaturated.
It excites me as a filmmaker that I want to be a part
hello.
Of.
Hello.
All right, well, he sounds excited about the project, not just for the money, so that's kind of cool.
Your career. What was it like being a video game villain?
No, I'm not a villain. I have to.
Yeah, you're never a villain.
I'll let you finish, but this guy loves his country. He wants to empower you, Keely. He wants to empower you.
Keely!
What is he holding in his hand?
Speak your truth. Now you can go back to calling
no cards, maybe, or something?
Yeah.
Well, you are smiling on the box. You're a good guy, right?
I am, because I feel like we as human beings fall in line. And
he's so committed to the character.
Yeah, he really. You guys remember Far Cry 5 is the villain? How do you
like that? Was like blazer and t-shirt, just by the way.
Part and parcel of sorry. Us falling in line and doing what
you guys remember
do,
Far Cry 5, that priest? He would like really did sermons and he was like really into the character. He did method.
Oh.
He was insane. He flew in on a helicopter and he had
a the game sucked.
And he was like, ladies and gentlemen. I have to send you those videos. They're insane. People, but this
guy, out of you see someone created
the trailer for this, Ryder?
Even if trailer for this Far Cry. Oh, it was great. I thought it was cool. Time, it's classic Far Cry, you know, just variation in guns, larger map.
Who did you base him on or study to create this character?
It's so
I'll buy it.
You see someone created all of GoldenEye within the Far Cry 5 level creator?
And it is Cuba.
I saw that.
An island that had so many resources, but really the dream of
you can have a companion of an alligator or like a little puppy.
Those resources, something got in the way there, and hopefully that can change in the years to come. It's funny you asked me that question, because I was just talking to one of my daughters about Ceausescu and also Hitler, because we were talking about zodiac signs and what signs were certain people. What is that mindset that has you wanting to have power over others? And for each dictator, it's different.
She
never heard of Ceausescu and studied political science and all this.
It's so interesting. He's so,
so, anyway, so
intelligent about this stuff.
Right, Jeff's so like, wrap it up. We got a lot of games.
Who would win in a square off between Gus Fring, Moff Gideon?
I want to talk to Giancarlo Esposito.
Moff Gideon,
you know,
for sure.
I have my favorites in those two. So you asked me this question.
Gus Fring.
And, you know, immediately, I say Moff Gideon.
Yes. He has the force at that.
You know, somehow I think Gus is colder and displays that coldness in a very particular way. You know, I think Anton could be the most violent man on Earth.
Oh, wow.
But given his situation,
is Anton his character in Far Cry 5?
To that mm-hmm. occasion, or may not have the time.
Far Cry 6? Or
Anton Castillo?
This Castillo, guy thinks in a different way, and he knows what you're thinking before you say it. And he does all his own dirty
I think,
work.
Like, there's a little boy from the reveal trailer is the brother to the main character. So there's connection with the villain and the main
thank you so much for
person you play as.
We will check out the revolution in Far Cry 6.
Oh, I'm so hyped.
And I
I'm buying
can't
it.
Wait for it to begin. Let the games begin!
Nice.
Awesome. All right. Thank you so much, Giancarlo. If you haven't picked up on it yet, Prime Gaming unlocks a ton of in-game benefits for Amazon Prime members, like an exclusive Valkyrie skin in Apex Legends, $200,000 in GTA cash every week to play GTA Online, and in Fall Guys, you get a
every
special
week.
Burning circus.
Oh, it's Anton's son? Okay, I thought he was also related to the
now,
main character. Maybe
Fall Guys, the
I just thought they looked like
a brand new costume coming to the game based on a legendary game franchise. Check it out.
Uh-oh.
What game?
I don't know. I didn't Apex? Catch it. Oh, Fall Guys.
What? What is Near Autonoma? Fall Guys.
Oh, my God.
It's 2B. Why?
Hilarious. What? The hair. It's the hair.
I love it. That's so funny.
I want to see James with that hair. Just bangs and stuff. It'd
He's
be hilarious.
That's funny.
Miuho Yo.
This is
how,
you, Ben.
This is how uncultured I am. I was like, Genshin Impact? I have no idea.
It is.
Oh,
Impact.
It is? Oh,
yes!
Yes! Oh, Sam,
who
we
is
got
that?
It. Let's go.
I got Gene. Guys, I pulled a 5-star this week.
I say fall automata.
You guys are fall automata.
Beast. Wow. Oh my god, it's a new area.
The new... I know, like, this doesn't look like the usual world.
Your opponent is new to the Clash, but he has quickly become the dark horse of the tournament. The vision is missing.
An Anemo character?
The sounds of nature turn into a clamor of noise during stormy weather.
Sword user. We had a lot of those.
The winds are coming.
Pedahara.
The birds come.
Wow. Genshin Impact.
I am in.
Play now. Blundell?
A publisher,
Jason Blundell?
A developer too.
Oh my god.
Dave Anthony and Jason Blundell from the newly formed DVA.
Tro, if you want to check it out, we have our reactions up on the YouTube channel for the trailer.
Over the years at Treyarch and Call of Duty Black Ops.
Arara?
What can we expect from your new studio, guys?
Dude, well, he left Treyarch for this.
Look, Jason and I,
man. Blundell created zombies from the ground up, man.
And we've been working together for decades. And we've worked on some huge franchises, you know the games, you know, they've done well. And but we thought, you know, when you're working on those franchises, the long established IPs, you're working within very, very tight constraints creatively about what you can do.
Well,
so we
thought
after all these years, you know,
or got fired apparently.
What if you deviated? So that's Deviation Games.
Okay. Deviation. So, wow, these guys are bad boys.
These guys are bad boys.
Yes, Ashton, we're going to upload the whole thing.
To work with creative
It'll be on our YouTube channel that's linked right above that.
Just to make a brand new IP, which is what we're doing.
We'll also have separate videos for like special stuff too. In case you don't want to watch the whole thing.
And the team at
like our Elden Ring reaction that we're going to have at the end of this,
right,
guys?
That'll be one for sure.
There's no place for ego. It's the best idea that always wins, and that's the
dude. I'm so happy for Blundell, man.
Well,
I follow that guy my whole life.
As we would expect. Now, I know it's very early, and there is nothing to show on the game today. But can you tell us?
Oh, Brambino, thank you for the raid, dude.
What can we expect?
Yeah, I mean,
Wait, hold on, shut up, guys.
A lot of exciting stuff going on. So essentially, we spent the last year building the team, right?
Thank
and
you, Disguised.
So what we knew was we wanted to collect passionate, creative, collaborative people and bring them together kind of
Thanks,
under one roof. And that's what Deviation Games is. So yeah, we don't have anything to show right now, but
what's up, Raptor?
Show. Imagination.
Doing great, man. You know, appreciate you, man. Watching Summer Games Fest. We got
Hangmine, what's good? Nokia too. Thank you so much for joining
Nokia.
In, guys.
Nokia.
Absolutely no info about the game. No.
It's a zombies game. No. Oh, here we go.
Oh, we got something.
Oh yeah.
No, this is just the dev team stuff. This isn't.
Oh, look at that.
While this is going on, thank you so much for the raid. Thank you, Brambino, for the follow.
Oh.
No, not Brambino. Brambino's not Brambino.
Brambino
raided. Okay. The RD follow.
I'm sorry. Thank you for following RD Disguise.
PlayStation?
Of course, he has a good relationship from zombies in Call of Duty.
Raptor, thank you so much for
following Raptor. From soup to nuts, this project is all about quality. This is brand new, Nokia, so don't worry about this.
I don't know either. Only the guy.
No one knows. This is brand new.
No. He's asking about the show. This show is called Summer Games Fest. They're announcing a bunch of new games right now. It's part of E3 week. Consistency of high quality games that they do. It's hit after hit.
It's award after award. And now we've been part of this process and we see how they do things.
It's really clear. Yeah, dude, we're stoked. Managing to accomplish that. So we
couldn't be more proud. Yeah, super fun. Portfolio. Thank you, Brambino.
Thanks, Brambino.
Have a good day.
No worries,
dude.
Nokia. Sony rocks, and they get our kind of part of E3. Yeah, pretty much. All right. Feels so bad. Deviation games,
PlayStation. This is the whole weekend. The whole weekend. It's like a giant weekend of game reveals and stuff. See you guys
again in the future. So, guys, does this mean that this is part of one of 25 Sony exclusives now? Deviation Games is going to be part of that.
Yeah, I count it. Yeah, it's going to be the whole weekend, up to Tuesday. We're going to see, like, Nintendo, Xbox. It's all kind of the same thing. Summer Games Fest,
yeah,
E3.
They both claim, they're both claiming the same thing. So. Mm-hmm. Technically, yeah.
Oh, is this Sonic? I didn't hear what... Yeah,
so
nice.
Raptors.
Yeah, this is Sonic Unleashed.
All right, guys, I can't stick around. Have a good stream. Thank you so much, Nokia. I appreciate it. Thanks for hanging out. Raptor, there is a schedule. If you follow our Twitter, too, we're going to be updating with all the ones that we're going to be live reacting to here. There's a lot throughout the week. But we're going to upload them all on our YouTube channel as well.
Yeah. Put that bad boy in there.
Perfect. Thanks, dude.
I remember playing this game on the Wii.
Yeah, Orchestra is great. Dude, I'll never forget. Remember when we saw the first orchestra and they did Spider-Man and God of War?
Dude, I had chills from that moment.
E3 of dreams, baby.
That was Game Awards, bro. When
Game
they
Awards
did the 2018?
I think it was 2018.
Coolest
Holy
night
crap.
Ever.
I'm talking about the God of War reveal.
Yeah.
Oh, the reveal, yeah. And that cool-ass theater.
Yeah.
Dude, I think we could get God of War at this thing today.
Think you're eating your own asshole.
I think we could.
Maybe. I'm like a 30%. I say 30%.
Sony
chance.
Is nowhere else this week. When's the next time they're gonna do it? Vinny on drugs.
Okay. Do you think there's more odds for Elden Ring or God of War than for their big?
I think Elden Ring.
Yeah, I see so.
Yeah,
that would be their
Ring
big,
for sure.
Their end game thing. Fable? Wasn't that their big thing? Fable announced.
No, that's no? Microsoft.
That'll be on Sunday. Which confirmed I got it off. I'm watching it, boys. We're ready.
Yeah. If it just tweets them like, see y'all Monday at 6 p.m.
Sony, state of play, Monday night, 6 p.m.
That'd be pretty cool. I wouldn't doubt it. That'd be sick.
I don't think they would do that.
Naughty Dog.
That's the thing. That'd be so surprising, bro.
And
I would love it.
They're like, special guests, Troy Baker and Nolan North. Oh! I'd lose it.
Yeah. Herman Holst just tweeted, honored to announce that PlayStation Studios is partnering with Dave Anthony, Jason Blundell, and their incredibly talented team at Deviation Games on a groundbreaking AAA new IP.
Wow. Cool. Yep.
So that's got to be one of them.
Blundell's huge, man. He ran Treyarch and all that.
It's awesome.
Oh, here we go. Love orchestra music. Yes. All right,
Sunday. Hey, this comes out on my birthday. Turtle
Rock will be giving Heck yeah. A new look at the zombie multiplayer fun of Back for Blood. And right now, we've got a quick tease of a new boss and news on the beta. Coming later this summer. I'm very excited to play this.
Oh, nice. I was gonna put that in my calendar, but it's already there. Your birthday.
Yeah. They're doing a whole panel for Back for Blood next week too. So.
Yeah. I got that on our schedule. I don't know if we're doing it though. I'm down to live react to it, but.
So a lot of people thought it was really funny that they did a piece from Sonic Unleashed.
Oh, yeah.
For the 30th anniversary.
Mm-hmm. They were like, yeah, no one's nostalgic about this game.
Grandson? What do you mean, grandson?
I don't get it, Raptor. I love that emote, dude.
August 5th.
Oh, the music got it.
Back for Blood. June
13th. Oh,
yeah,
PvP showcase. One of the things I didn't know they were doing PvP.
Oh, I see. You guys access to play more games
at home.
Last year, Steam and Xbox did incredible demo events.
I forgot that the lizard is the new Pog champ.
And this year, Steam's Next Fest starts next Wednesday, and Xbox is back again to do an ID at Xbox demo event, which I'm announcing right now.
Whoa.
It starts on Tuesday and is completely free. No badges required. One of the games I'm most excited about in the lineup is Tunic.
Another shot at E3. Jeff is going to throats this stream. And Canada, another Canada reference.
You can exclusively play on Xbox starting on Tuesday.
Tuesday? What is it? Please give me something good. I need more.
Hi, my name is Andrew Scholdeis, and I'm working on Tunic, which is an isometric
one-man team.
Little studio.
Yeah, yeah.
Where you explore the wilderness, fight monsters,
yo.
I first started working on it about 6 years ago.
Oh, little fox.
And it's been changing a lot over the years, but
I love that.
I don't think Sony will have a show, but I feel like other companies will mention Sony.
In Tunic.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Jeez.
You are a little fox that's washed up on a beach, and you don't have a lot of context except for, you know, a lust for adventure, and you are going to wander off, and maybe you're going to find a stick, and maybe if you venture a little bit further, maybe you're going to find a sword. And it's really about that.
Oh, this is cool. I like this.
Wondering what's
this guy seems so awesome.
People have played the game at shows before, but we wanted to put together a brand new demo that was, you know, for the home audience. And so
this is cool.
Never before seen stuff, a brand new dungeon, a bunch of areas people haven't seen before.
Okay, cool.
So excited about Tunic, and Sable also is going to be one of the games in that, along with a lot of other awesome
ID
titles.
At Xbox. Cool.
On Xbox. I can play Sable!
Next up, stave off Ragnarok in this ancient Norse-inspired co-op action survival
God of
RPG.
War.
You can also fully play solo. Classic hack-and-slash gameplay goes Viking
hack and
in Norsefell's Tribes of Midgard, launching on PlayStation and PC July 27th.
About the Jeff Keighley mask.
A brand new trailer.
Nice. Those redeems, like, will they run out today? Can I do it later today?
No, it's 15 right minutes during the stream. That's why I've just had it up.
What?
You have to watch it 15 minutes.
Okay. What do you have to have up? The Prime Gaming website or the Twitch website?
The Game Awards Twitch page. I don't even like Among Us, but...
Yeah, it's just silly to have it.
Return to your village and use those resources to forge Viking-worthy gear. You must protect the seed of Yggdrasil at all costs, or this world and everything in it will be destroyed forever.
I don't care at all about this game.
Wow, 160,000 people watching? That's huge.
That's just on Twitch.
Yeah.
YouTube's got more.
Mm-hmm. 174,000 on YouTube.
Oh, I got it.
Oh, heck yeah, you did.
Nice.
Love it. Comes great rewards.
But be careful. You're of little use to Midgard, squashed by a troll.
I really want a good dungeon crawling game with your friends that you get good loot at the end, and
Diablo,
it's rewarding every time you play.
Yeah, Diablo. Literally Diablo. And it's time for us to Cheesy, thank you.
3? Or should I just wait?
Diablo 3 is so good. And it goes on sale for dummy cheap.
As the saying goes, Valhalla can wait.
I've told you about Diablo before, Ben.
I know. If they fix graphics and voiceovers, this could be a nice casual game. Oh, I like the graphics. It's fine.
Yeah, it's the design, the art.
Who's ready?
Your box
some
also.
Evil
oh no,
dead.
I dropped
evil
my game.
Dead, yes.
Game last December at TGA, and now
I forgot about this.
For an extended look at the gameplay. To tell us more,
and I love Bruce. Any more Bruce in my life?
From Saber.
Hi Jeff, it's great to see you. Today,
this guy's got a sick setup.
Oh my god, is it a fourth scale Iron Man?
Excited to show you this.
So sick.
To help me explain,
I want a whole desk room.
Bruce Campbell. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. An office.
I want more figures.
I want more big figures.
Boss Team Games.
It looks good. It looks great. Graphics-wise, holy crap.
Yeah, this is very pretty.
Wow. So you have F-13 in a way? You guys ever play Friday the 13th? Silly one.
Yeah. It does remind me.
Cinematic Attack?
Hola, cyber friends.
It's like Dead by Daylight meets Friday the 13th.
You know me as Ash Williams, the dude who saved the world from...
I just think of the original Spider-Man game. He's giving you the tutorial. You know what I'm talking about? Bruce Campbell? Yeah, but I didn't play the first Spider-Man game back in like 2007 or...
Oh, I didn't know that he did that voiceover. That's hilarious.
The tutorial? You want to swing, yeah. Hold the right trigger or whatever.
That's so funny.
The first Toby game.
If you're not into the whole save the world thing, we have another option.
Oh, wow. Yes, the cars to get an escape. This is like Friday the 13th.
The vile Kandarian demon itself. But who would want to do that? He'd be a dick. The power of possession in your arsenal.
Love it.
You'll scare those goody two shoes to death. Literally, you can do that if you're a dick.
Good point. Spitters. Good point, Cheesy.
Whether you choose the path of evil,
yeah, Ash. Ash.
You'll be thrown down in places you've seen before.
I need to watch the Evil Dead movies. I've only seen Army of Darkness.
Uncover Nobi's lost tapes and track down other legendary artifacts. When you've grabbed enough, you'll use a spell to send the Kandarian son of a bitch back to the hellhole it came from.
That gun sounded cool.
This looks really great. Like,
yeah.
It's not often you see games looking like this. Wow.
No HUD yet, though.
It was no accident that Ash always wore brown pants.
Bioshock? That's a big question, Cheesy. You know what? I think yes. There's been chatter about the developer.
There has been.
The aim is awful.
Did you hear that BioShock was going to go open world? And then I saw a bunch of tweets that was like, I want more open world games going linear instead. I don't want this to happen.
Yep, I've been seeing so many like that. Because so many games are going to open world now.
I have really bad open world fatigue right now, especially after Days Gone. I have no desire to touch an open world game right now.
I remember you said that like a year and a half ago on some episode or something we talked about.
That's why I'm taking a break from Nier Automata, because that's a super open world game and it takes forever to go across the map.
Yeah.
And so it's just like every time I play that game, I just get stupid tired.
It was like back to back for me. It was Cyberpunk, Ghost of Tsushima, and then Days Gone. That's since December.
Okay, I'm in Valhalla. 7 months. And that open world is ridiculous.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, grand finale. This is it.
Is extremely special.
Elden Ring.
Today, I am so deeply honored to be given the opportunity to share this next game. It comes from one of our industry's most acclaimed developers and a previous Game of the Year winner at
Game of the Year.
Yep, Sekiro.
I personally thank this developer for believing in my vision of Summer Game Fest as a new way to bring all of us together for a cross-industry showcase.
Say it, Jeff.
Kick off the summer in the
say
right
their
way.
Name.
So.
Come on!
Shut up.
Sit back and enjoy this truly spectacular world premiere. It is finally
he's excited.
Time.
He's excited. Oh. He's excited.
What the heck?
It's Jeff! You know! Oh,
come on, baby! Come on, baby!
It's Elden Ring. It's Elden Ring.
Yes. Oh!
Is it? That's it, right?
It's fucking it! Yes!
Wow. Nice. We got it.
I'm going to Twitter right now.
George R. R. Martin.
Yeah!
I'll look at it later. I'll look at it later. I'll look at Twitter after.
Yeah, okay.
Enjoy it.
Guided by grace.
Wow.
Once lost.
Everyone needs to shut the fuck up.
The Golden Order is broken to its core.
Wow. Oh, yo. Wow. It's all quiet.
Foul tarnished.
Foul tarnished.
Of the Elden Ring. Emboldened by the flame.
Oh my god.
Someone must extinguish thy flame.
Wow. James's face.
That was so cool.
Ooh.
Yes, Raptor.
You can be a werewolf. Or maybe that was just an enemy.
That would be awesome.
Oh!
Oh my god.
Jeez, that's insane. What the heck? Oh, that was cool.
Oh!
Lowly tarnished. Playing as a lord.
Oh.
I command thee.
Oh!
Big old chonker.
Yep. No way, a bull is that?
It's just a death animation reel.
Whoa, these guys look awesome.
What?
Man.
Holy cow.
So much.
Uniqueness. Whoa, the wings? Epic. Oh. Ashton is in. This looks so fucking good.
Round of applause. Round of applause for that.
Wow.
Hey, come on!
Wow, it's actually coming out? This game is releasing?
Actually happened.
Wow.
Elden Ring is coming, as you saw, January 21st, 2022 to next gen.
Current gen, too.
And I want to thank so much Miyazaki-san and the team at
my neighbors think I'm insane.
In-game look at Elden Ring. I hope you guys are happy. Oh my god, I'm free out of prison. All right.
He doesn't have to reveal it.
Free.
Best kickoff live. Thank you so much to all the developers who took part and for you and watching.
Way to start off
the
summer, guys.
So much to me. Summer Game Fest continues all weekend with Netflix Geeked Week and
Prime. I'm not sure. Is it, guys?
Ubisoft Forward on
what?
Saturday,
John's asking. Is it the new Dark Souls title? Elden Ring.
Square Enix. It's the same company. It's like, but it's not. James, it's not in the Dark Souls world, right? No. Yeah, it's just the same company,
same developer studio.
That I'm fully supportive of, and I'm very excited to see what they have.
Man, I can't wait to see other companies.
As for me, I'll see you again on August 25th for Gamescom Opening Night Live. And this December, I am so happy to say that the Game Awards will return
at the
in-person ceremony.
Go, we're going! No way,
Let's buy tickets. We're buying tickets.
Yes! Holy crap, we're getting tickets, guys. We gotta go.
I'm telling you, that was the best night of my best memories I've ever made.
Yes!
Wow.
Right now. Good night, everybody.
Amazing.
Oh, yes, I'm so excited.
Tickets to the Game Awards,
YouTube, you cowards.
It's Game Rewards 2021.
What a time, guys. What a freaking
time. Drop the trailer from Software.
So you can watch it again?
I'm trying to send it to a buddy of mine.
That was it. I'm going to stop it in a little bit. I'm going to start the recording. Ready?
Yeah, you can stop the recording. Hey, let's finish it off.
All right, here we go.
Go
Hi,
for
buddy.
It.
Hello and welcome.